Hello everyone, this is Sushma from Techcanvass. The topic that we are going to learn would be web services concepts. Before we jump to the actual concepts of web services, let us understand what an API means. API is nothing but application program interface, which is a protocol or a routine which helps to build various software applications. API or the application program interface also helps us to communicate between two applications. So in general, we can say that web services are application program interface which facilitates the interaction between two machines over a network. Now we know what is an API, we will try and understand web services through a couple of examples. I request you to please refer the diagram on the screen. Say it's a weekend, you and your friend plan for a party and you both walk into Pizza Hut and settle down on one of the tables. There is a kitchen in the Pizza Hut which prepares food and serves to different customers. This means that there is some kind of communication happening between you, your friend and the kitchen. Now, as you are in the Pizza Hut, you do not directly walk into the kitchen to place the order. Instead, you place the order through a waiter. The waiter, who in turn goes to the kitchen, places the order and serves you the food. Here the waiter acts as a web service who communicates between you, your friend and the kitchen. So now let us take another example of booking flight through ClearTrip application. Say we book a flight from Mumbai to Bangalore. We select the source, the destination, the date of travel and click on search flight button. I have captured the screenshot and is displayed on the screen. So when you click on the search flight button, what do you see? You see a result screen which has the details of all the flights of various airlines like Vistara, Go Air, Indigo, Air India and so on. How you think this is happening? Is this being fetched from the ClearTrip database and shown across? No, not really. Here the airlines like Vistara, Go Air, Air India and all other airlines have exposed their web services and ClearTrip is consuming their web services to get the flight details on the screen. So now with these two examples in mind, let us define web services. Web services are nothing but services that are available over the web. Web services is always exposed from the application server of an application. Application server is where the business logic, the methods, and the functions are stored. Web services acts as a channel between the two applications which are developed in the same language or a different language. To explain this, let us consider this example. Say ClearTrip is developed on Java and the Vistara application on .NET. Irrespective of languages on which the applications are developed, web services acts as a channel of communication. Web services provides a standard format for communication. About format messages, we will learn more about it in our upcoming tutorials. Web services also helps in data exchange. Now with this, we shall see how we can create web services. Web services can be created in two different ways, using SOAP and using REST. We will learn more about SOAP and REST in our next slides. SOAP is a protocol and the full form of SOAP is Simple Object Access Protocol. In SOAP, the request and the response are sent in the form of an XML. Here, XML is a markup language, and the full form of XML is Extensible Markup Language, which helps us in data exchange. Let's move further. So what are the advantages of SOAP? SOAP works on HTTP protocol. As we already know that HTTP protocol is the default protocol for all the web application. SOAP is platform independent. That means that it can work on any programming language. SOAP has the ability to run on different operating systems such as Windows and Linux. Let's move on to REST. REST is Representational State Transfer. It obeys the REST protocol. In REST, the request is sent in the form of an URL and the response is either in the form of an XML or JSON. JSON is a lightweight format for storing and transporting data. JSON full form is JavaScript Object Notation. Let's talk about advantages of REST. In REST, everything we work with is treated as a resource. Here, resource is the information that API provides on an object. We either create an object, create a resource, overwrite a resource, modify the state of the resource using various HTTP methods like put, get, post, and delete. REST is stateless, which means that the session data is not stored on the client. With this, I'm going to end this session. More on format messaging will be taken in upcoming tutorials. I hope this was useful to you. Thank you.